Hello, fans of patterns made out of large circles and of cryptocurrencies. I am Alex, your Crypto Robin host, and today we are going to take a look at one of the most famous projects that's part of the crypto world, Polkadot. For the latest news and reviews of the crypto space, you can find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Telegram. We'll leave the links in the description below and in the pinned comment. Join us and stay up to date. What is Polkadot? Polkadot represents a platform that lets various blockchains transfer messages, including value, in a trust-free way. In short, Polkadot is a scalable multi-chain technology. The final goal of Polkadot is to be the new internet of blockchains that will be able to communicate with one another without any problem. But you may ask, with so many platforms out there, some of them being pretty great, why do we need another one? Simply put, the creators of Polkadot don't think that a single blockchain is capable of serving all purposes with the needed efficiency, or as fast as needed, or as secure as needed. One blockchain couldn't support billions of smart contracts, all with various applications. This is why Polkadot is trying to bring all blockchains in one room and offer the best platform for any project, regardless of what you may have in mind. How does Polkadot work? Polkadot represents a new generation blockchain protocol that seriously simplifies cross-chain communication by guiding a collective of blockchains into one network. This network is to be secured by a grandpa algorithm created especially for Polkadot. The most important parts of the Polkadot network are relay chain, parachains, parathreads, and bridges. The relay chain represents the pillar of the Polkadot network and is the main communication hub between parachains. Validators on this chain are the ones who accept blocks from all parachains, which means they are in charge of keeping the entire network secure. Parachains represent independent blockchains that run on top of the relay chain and offer chain-specific features to the Polkadot network. All parachains have a specialized purpose in this network. Imagine having a fine-tuned chain for smart contracts, another one in charge of stablecoin payments between chains, and so on. Each of the parachains is maintained by the collator, which has the responsibility of producing chain blocks. Parachains also enjoy a shared security model offered by the relay chain so that they'll be secured against 51% of the attacks. Still, only a select number of parachains will be permitted on the network for now, although there is a plan for the number to expand in the future. There are plans for public auctions in which parachain candidates will need to compete with each other so that they would get their own slot. From a technical point of view, parathreads are similar to parachains, but from an economic point of view, there's a world of difference between them. Unlike a parachain, which has to compete to get a spot on the network, a parathread slot can be leased almost immediately, but just for a short period of time. This will create a different way of running projects on Polkadot, since it could let you try out the network before buying an expensive parachain slot, for example. Finally, we have bridges. They have the role of connecting already running blockchains into the ecosystem, like a Bitcoin or Ether, and permit the transfer of tokens between Polkadot and outside networks. As a result of its structure, Polkadot has many advantages when compared to other blockchains, like scaling, specialization, cooperation, or governance. Let's talk about scaling. You probably know about the insane fee transactions required by Ethereum or other similar problems encountered by other blockchains. Such issues come from the fact that every node in the network is asked to process all transactions one by one. But Polkadot is different, because parachains will run and produce their blocks in parallel, while validators are in charge of everything after that. This is especially great news for the speed of the network. What about specialization? Well, in general, blockchains are trying to support several features at once, so they have to come up with some trade-offs. With Polkadot, one parachain can be deployed for file storage, another one for decentralized identity management, and another one for enabling payments. Things get so much easier when you skip the code part. Furthermore, Polkadot already offers a simple SDK named Substrate, which can make creating and deploying parachains very easy, so you don't have to write any code from scratch. Regarding cooperation, we can say that Polkadot parachains aren't going to run in isolation, but they are able to communicate with one another. This isn't just limited to effortless token transfers, but it can also carry messages. The cross-chain messaging protocol is the one that lets parachains to send messages of any kind. Last but not least, we have governance, which means that the Polkadot community is able of governing the network in a way that is decentralized completely. The community is planned to be in charge of parachain's actions, number of slots, and anything else that you can think of. Say goodbye to hard fork. All blockchains require an update every now and then, and they usually ask for a hard fork, especially when an important change is made to the network. This isn't always received well by the user community, as we saw happening with Bitcoin Cash. Polkadot stands out because it lets its parachains and even its own network to update without any hard fork needed. The Polkadot ecosystem is ever growing as development teams notice the advantages of the network from flexibility to security. The fusion of several specialized chains into one highly scalable and interconnected network lets any blockchain to reach its complete potential. In this case, projects don't need to compete with each other, as they are now working together in the Polkadot network in order to reach independence from the centralized world. Some of the projects associated with the Polkadot ecosystem include Akala Network, Energy Web Token, ChainX, Sora, Robonomics, and others. Polkadot was created by a team around Web3 Foundation that aims for a decentralized web. The leading figure of the project is Dr. Gavin Wood, known for being a founding father of Ethereum and author of the Solidity Smart Contract Programming Language. We also have Robert Habermeyer, co-founder of Polkadot, who has a vast experience in research and development of decentralized networks and cryptography, but also Peter Tsaban, who puts to use his experience in financial and data industries. The Polkadot token. The DOT token can be used for several purposes, including governance, staking, bonding, and for fees. It currently has a market cap of over $27 billion, which makes it the 8th most valuable cryptocurrency in the world. Polkadot passed through its ICO in October of 2017, and the price for one DOT was $28.80. It was also one of the best performing ICO ever made, and the project raised $145 million in the first round of sales. One important milestone for the project is the collaboration with Kusama. Kusama is a live network with real economic incentives and will help in creating ground for parachains, thus letting the community notice how the network acts and make new tests on it. Kusama was created to allow taking risks, being basically a cousin network for Polkadot serving as a canary. Kusama governance will begin by enabling parachain functionality through a runtime upgrade. Next, it has the possibility of starting the slot auctions or to add common good parachains. Parachain slot leases will be assigned using non-permissioned candle auctions. Following the first auction on Kusama, a new auction will happen around 2 weeks later. After every auction, the winning parachain will be deployed to the network when the lease session begins. Auctions are programmed to continue from there on a rolling basis, as a higher number of slots will be available and all leases are no longer valid. Following the completion of all audits and with parachains running smoothly on Kusama, the Polkadot community will have the option of enabling parachain functionality, deploy the first public good parachains, and start slot auctions on Polkadot using on-chain governance. As for final thoughts, it's clear that interoperability and scaling represent the next important step in the blockchain industry, which is why Polkadot is the one that will bring blockchain to the 3.0 era, which is bound to change the landscape forever. This will bring the last missing piece needed by the industry, and with it, new and interesting projects will rise, bringing to life previously unseen use cases for decentralized networks and currencies. Thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell to be notified when we publish a new video. Happy summer to all!